This is how we do it.
I got something really cool to say,
too. Can you get back here a little?
I want to say something awesome right here. You know, we had a hunt where we actually were in the edge of the corn, and the deer was as close as that right there. You're talking about intimidation. We had thousands of people tell us, man, something happens when we get too close to a deer. It gives us the jitters. We get buck fever and everything. How would you like to be on a caribou hunt and have a 6-foot-wide caribou rack come behind a pile of rocks and step out right in front of you, 3 feet in front of you? That'll really intimidate you. But in that hunt that we did, it was a beautiful day just like this, winds blowing and everything. And there again, so many people don't hunt when the wind's blowing. They think that, you know, it's a disadvantage. Now, I wouldn't be here hunting with the wind blowing like that. We would be on the other side of this field hunting into the wind. Deer play the wind. They play the wind, and on a windy like this, they'll be bedded all day. This is spooky stuff for them. So anyways, don't be intimidated if you walk up on a deer. Like me and Kevin was out in the back of my barn the other day, and I said, Kevin, you wouldn't believe how many deer are right here all the time. And Kevin said, you mean like those three standing there right now? They were just standing there looking at us. So you got to take advantage of those situations. So, well, I know this is close. Don't let that buck, if you don't see his head, you don't know he's a buck. So anyways, just don't be intimidated by him getting too close like that. This is how we do it. That's a shot right there Kevin loves. He likes them heart shots, man. That arrow going right through the center of that heart. So anyways, that's the tip of the day right there. If you want to hunt cornfields, if you don't have good cover in the areas where you're hunting, and not everybody has a 1,000-acre food plot. Most people have a 3 or 4 or 5 acre piece of land that they hunt, and they got one tree, and then they're hunting on a cornfield. If you see deer going in and out of that cornfield 100 yards from your stand, and there's no trees down there, what are you gonna do? You get out of your stand and go down there and wait for those deer to come through there the next day. That's how we do this stuff. We're very successful. I mean, our whole family, you know, all of Kevin's grandkids and everything, we kill deer when we go hunting, and that's why we hunt.